Hello everyone, today I want to talk about getting started with Modbus Monitor XPF software. If you don't have the trial version installed, check out the trial version from a Microsoft store. My other videos discusses the advantage of this software compared to the others in the market and various ways to get the software. Alright, let's get started. Launch Modbus Monitor XPF from the Windows Start button. The program starts with a Home tab. This is where you manage the Modbus Monitor points, Modbus map configuration, and open or save files. The File section has standard Windows File Open and Save options. Click Open to open the file. The Modbus Monitor saves monitor points in the standard CSV format that can be edited by Windows Notepad or Excel to have greater control over the configuration and editing. The CSV file also comes in handy to compare versions using a file dip tools or source control. The Clipboard section also comes in handy for copying and pasting existing monitor points. We will show some use later in the video. The List section has option to manage monitor points and set global Modbus map address offset 0 or 1. The Filter section contains an index of a monitor point selected. The Filter text box filters registers. Try holding the mouse and a quick help text pops up. This shows the total rows in the list below. The Log section shows switching the view to traffic log so you can monitor traffic in real time. The log can also be turned on and off from the quick ribbon menu. Let's cover the basics of how to manage monitor points. Select single monitor point and click either the delete button on the keyboard or the minus icon. You can also select multiple monitor points serially by dragging the mouse, or pick the first monitor point, go to end, hold shift key and click the delete button. You can also select multiple monitor point, not in any order, by holding the control key and selecting the multiple point. Deleting monitor points. Delete single monitor point by selecting a row or clicking a delete. You can also click the cut icon to delete and save for pasting later. Click delete all to delete all monitor points in the list below. Delete deletes individual or multiple monitor points. Adding monitor points. Add button adds single monitor point. On the next add, the software automatically increments the address based on the data type. For example, if the data type is set to 64-bit values, the software calculates the correct amount of registers, 4 registers for 64-bit values, and calculates the next start registers. We will discuss setting Modbus monitor points in detail in other videos. You can also add monitor points from a clipboard's paste function. The paste function adds the monitor points at the end of the list. As mentioned earlier, you can also use Notepad or Excel to move monitor points with a better control. Filter. The filter comes in handy when you want to filter the list based on a word contained in the name or actual address. This comes in very handy to change the value back and forth on one out of many items. Click on the delete filter icon to go back to show the complete list. The File tab gives option to manage files and folders and changes themes. Home takes you to the Documents folder. Open folder opens folder to Windows Explorer. Up arrow icon moves up the folder. Recent shows the file that are recently opened. Theme. You have the option to use a light or dark or default theme. The default theme automatically uses the setting from our Windows. Client mode turns the Modbus Monitor XPF into Modbus Client or Master to pull the remote servers. The tab deserves the video on its own. We will cover this tab in other videos. Server mode turns the Modbus Monitor XPF into the Modbus server or Modbus slave, a simulator for remote clients. The tab deserves the video on its own. We will cover this tab in a future video. Alright, this is a quick look at Modbus Monitor XPF Windows software. Give Modbus Monitor XPF application a try if you don't have it already. It is available in Windows Store, risk-free 30-day trial version. Check my other videos on how to get one and install. And like the video. Let me know down in the comment which videos would be helpful to make next. If you want to see more videos like this in the future, please consider subscribing. Alright, this is all I have for you today. I hope you enjoy. See you next time. Bye.